We're going to go live soon.
Okay.
9 weeks have come and gone, and we are at the last scheduled home game of the season. Up here in the press box here at Fullerton District Stadium, Ian Diaz, Soham Dev, pleased to be here for our Troy Warrior Football Senior Night. The Warriors are on a 3-game winning streak and are hot after a huge win over La Habra, headlined by Ethan Munt's 2-touchdown performance and star receivers Declan Healy and Vander Ploeg, who combined for a total of 154 yards and 2 touchdowns. On the other side of the ball, junior Tommy Inou had a sack and 4 tackles, 2 of which were for a loss. On the other hand, Buena Park has lost both of their league games so far and is looking to get their first win. BP here is a run-heavy offense starring Jaden Moore and Danny Washington. Both teams definitely have areas of excellence. Let's see how this one plays out on Friday the 13th in our last home game of the year.
Isn't that just great when Friday the 13th lines up in October?
That's such a great day, man.
Really, it is.
Like double spookiness of Friday the 13th and October.
I know. I think Halloween is like my third favorite holiday.
Favorite?
Yeah. It would be Christmas, 4th of July, and then
Halloween.
Halloween, right.
Yeah, I think that's a pretty good top three. Let's see how we get some Friday the 13th elements in this game, maybe.
You know what? I'm hoping for a spooky game.
I'm hoping maybe a lot of trick plays.
Ooh,
that'd
wow.
be cool.
Trick or treat, yeah.
Some more ring around the rosy like we saw in week one.
That's right. Against the Fountain Valley Barons.
Fountain Valley Barons, yeah.
That was fun. I doubt that Buena Park is as
I don't think they have as sophisticated of an offense as
Fountain
Valley.
Yeah. That was a good game. That was a close one.
It was a close one. Went down to the wire. Last play of the game.
We're pretty excited up here in the box to see how this game turns out. We're kind of expecting a blowout, but...
A blowout? Let's not jinx it here.
Right. I'm not... You're right.
I mean, last time I said we're going to win the game, it was against Fountain Valley. Let's see how that... We saw how that one turned out.
To be fair, it was the first game of the entire season.
It was. We're just getting those first game jitters out.
Right. So now we can... We know what we can expect from both our offense and defense.
As we see the captains of both teams going out to the 50-yard line. For the Warriors, we have number 17, Jacob Guangarena, the senior safety. Then we have number 5, Jacob Popoka, the senior middle linebacker. We also have number 8, Charles Lynn, the senior D lineman. Alongside them is Declan Healy, a star player we've said his name a lot through these games. The 6'2", 190 senior.
6'2", that's a lot of... You know what, but it's not as much as Vander Ploeg.
As Vander Ploeg.
That's a lot.
On the Buena Park side, we see number 6, Alex Delgado, the senior 5'8", 172 quarterback. We also see number 55, Jesus Sandoval, the starting center for the Buena Park there.
We also have number 54, Danny Washington.
Daniel Washington. He's actually been a really big force on defense. Oh, sorry. And Oxley at running the ball. They actually use him as a running back sometimes.
Really?
Perhaps.
That's like a rhino coming at you.
Like a Christian Okoye or something like that.
Yeah.
Buena Park will be kicking off here shortly to the Warriors as we've said a lot, in our senior night, the last scheduled home game of the year. Hopefully not the last home game of the year. Maybe we make CIF and get a home field game.
That would be nice.
If that happens, you know where to watch it, right here on TRHS Omnia.
And if not, we have certainly enjoyed being your announcers.
Definitely. This whole year, myself, so I've been announcer at all these games, Ian, almost all these games.
If you were wondering where I was at this last game, I was producing that last
got
production.
Got a promotion there, actually.
A little bit.
It's a little promotion.
But you know what? I miss my place back here as an announcer, talking all kinds of things about both teams.
As we see our wonderful cheer, they're ready to introduce our Warriors. The sounds of the band in the background. This environment, something I'll never get tired of.
It really is a lively environment. Even if we're facing somebody like the Buena Park Coyotes, it's still a lively crowd.
Yeah, as we see the marching band walk out under Wally the Warrior. And the moment you've been waiting for, all of our Troy Warrior football team. You see, ready to walk out as the Buena Park Coyotes take the field right here. But there,
number eight, Charles Lynn.
And the Warriors take the field on their last home game of the year. Charles Lynn, number eight, running out with a flag, followed by Rudy Alcala and Vanderpool.
Certainly has been quite a year for these Troy Warriors, right? There you see Rudy Alcala.
Quarterback there. He's had some highs, definitely had some lows.
Definitely.
The highs have been high and the lows have been low. That's what I'll say.
Yeah, yes, they have. There's been high peaks and low canyons.
So what we're coming off of, last week we had our first win against La Habra in, I believe, 7 years. The first time Coach Chavez has ever beat the La Habra Highlanders.
That was certainly a shock to me. I wasn't expecting that.
Definitely gave us a huge morale boost, maybe going to carry into this game and play a huge factor. What are we thinking here? Do we think we see more of a close game, or are we seeing like a lot of separation near that second half that kind of gets out of hand?
I want to say there's going to be a lot of separation between the Warriors and the Coyotes. Mostly from the Warrior offense, getting all those long passes from Rudy Alcala. Probably we can see a lot of Vander Ploeg and Declan Healy action.
As the kickoff is shortly to begin. Back there for the Coyotes, number 57 for the kickoff. That's going to be Emmanuel Rodriguez, dual kicker and punter. And we are underway here at Fullerton District Stadium. And we see a Troy kind of kickoff. Though we saw that earlier in the Troy season. That's a really short kickoff near the sideline.
And it is a fair catch by Vander Ploeg.
Made at the 35-yard line. So we're going to have pretty good field position to start this drive.
Yeah, it really is. And we don't normally see the Warriors get the ball this first play.
Yeah, it's usually we're the ones deferring.
Right, and then we kick a squib kick or an onside kick.
We shifted away from that, which is
good. I'm glad we did, honestly.
As let's see what the Warriors will do on this first play. What do you think they're doing? I think they're going with a run. How about you?
I most definitely can see a run play coming up here.
You see Vander Ploeg lined up wide, not even in the huddle. So that kind of plays into it being a run. And it is a handoff there to Declan Healy, who gets shot there by number 3, Jerron Johnson Jr., freshman on varsity.
We don't normally see a freshman on varsity. Yeah, no, for any sports for that matter, actually. It's quite a sight to see a freshman. I believe they have multiple freshmen on their roster.
They indeed do.
Whereas the Warriors don't have any freshmen, right?
I don't believe so, as that's a great start for the Coyotes. A 2-yard loss. Declan Healy here breaks the top, finds the gap, going down the side of the second play of the game. 30, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Warriors! Declan Healy on the second play of the game after getting blown up the first, finds the gap, jukes the defender, runs all the way down the sideline for the Warriors touchdown. What an electric start to this game.
I don't know about you, Swan, but I'm looking at what could be the rest of this game.
If the rest of the game looks how that first drive went, I think we might see a blowout. What
they
a play
They did the exact same play, and the Coyotes didn't see it coming at all. Declan Healy is just so fast. I believe he has like a 22-mile-per-hour run clock.
Caleb Huss there for the extra point. Extra point is good. Speaking about Caleb Huss, we've seen his role diminish a bit in these past few games.
Right, taken over by Ethan Muntz as RB.
Wow, Ethan Muntz, if you don't know, he's been climbing up the ranks. The first game he had like a 1, maybe 2 carries, but every game he's steadily been getting more and more carries, more and more touches, more and more opportunities. Last game, he was the core factor in our win over La Habra. He got 2 touchdowns in that game.
He's definitely been a big factor in this Warrior offense. Here we can see
the Troy kicking ready to kick off. I don't think they were expecting to kick off this quickly.
I certainly wasn't either.
It's almost as if they wanted to toss and decide to kick, but got a 7-point lead in the win.
There we are. Caleb Huss, who we were talking about earlier, who moved down as a kicker. I shouldn't say moved down. It's not a demotion. It's not. He just got moved to kicker. It's not that it's any less than an RB.
Yeah.
It's just as important. Yeah. Without a good kicker.
Like two games, both the last two games, we won or lost by only 1 point, 135-34 against Fullerton there because of a block that went. So kicking is a really important factor. And the kickoff for Troy is underway. Hey, look, not a squib kick. Fields around the 10-yard line there. He's number 26 for the Coyotes. Cuts back inside and dragged down there by number 43 on the Warriors. Caleb Heroes, the 6'1 junior middle linebacker, wraps him up.
Before we were the broadcast started, we were talking about Caleb Quiroz and how he was a soccer player in his early days as goalie. And he certainly shifted to the better side of his athletic ability.
All right, and we'll get a first look at these Coyotes taking the field. They are a very run-heavy offense, as we said in the intro there. What they actually do is whenever they – most of the times they run the ball, but when they pass, they're usually just used to pass as an extension of the run game, right, going for those short checkdowns, which if you're viewing at home, you might think that's not very effective, but Troy has been not very good at these short checkdown passes. Fountain Valley ran all over them with them.
Yeah, it was very disappointing.
Very infuriating to watch.
Yeah, it really is.
As we see three receivers out wide, two people in the backfield. Bit of a fumble with a snap there as we see a running back go up the middle for about 13 yards there. That's number 5, Danny Washington, we talked about there in the intro. Definitely their head back there. They run more of a dual-headed running system there.
Right, yeah. That's what we were mistaken for as a fumble fumble of the ball. It was just
juggling.
Them passing the ball around like a hot potato. Look at him. He runs right up the middle and then the – he's tackled by number 81,
Adam
Knowles.
As we see four receivers to the left.
No, Josh King.
And the refs start to walk on the field. The whistle's blown. Some confusion out here on the field as we get a sub, number 11 walking off. Number 14, Francisco Flores, walking onto the field. But four receivers to the left here on stack formation. I'm thinking maybe a wide receiver screen. A wide receiver screen. And it's almost picked up by Jacob Guangarena. And he's going down the sideline. He breaks off. Luckily pushed out of bounds. Could have gone all the way there.
I believe that was Hayden Sanchez who pushed him out of bounds. Number 21. Here he breaks one tackle. And then number 81. No. I'm sorry. That was Josh King who pushed him out.
Josh King who pushed him out there. As we see trips right here for the Coyotes. One receiver to the left. Running back in the backfield. Number 8 in motion. Goes back out, takes a snap, looks to be an inside zone there to Danny Washington, who trucks forward for about 4 or 5 yards.
Danny Washington is 225 pounds, standing up at 5'11". That's a lot. And imagine that coming at you. Dense guy. Good vocabulary. There he is. We see him being brought down by number 3, Jerron Johnson. Tomi Inu.
As four receivers out wide this time. I think that as maybe a false start could have been called there on a receiver as.
And it is incomplete.
Drop there.
Drop by number 8, Anthony Irons.
I think maybe Aaron Rodriguez might have had a false start on that play, the receiver there. Refs did not call it.
Anthony Irons is supposed to be a pretty good wide receiver for the Buenaparte Coyotes. He has around about 500 yards average.
500 yards on the
I believe so, if
season,
I remember
yeah.
quite.
As once again, see three receivers to the right. They're running a lot of wide sets here. And a hand of play action there. Pressure coming.
Almost sacked.
Quarterback scrambling, rolling out right. And he darts it there to number 8, that being Anthony Irons once again. As that's his second touch of the game in just as many times this drive. Picks up a first down there at the 45-yard line.
He was able to redeem himself and keep both feet inside the bounds.
The Coyotes are starting Saxton, a freshman at quarterback here. Which is a very interesting.
Yeah,
as we see
is.
Three suits to the right. Ooh, and number 15 there. That's going to be Ethan Munt on defense getting called for a neutral zone infraction maybe.
Yeah, most likely. You saw him there charging in the center.
Trying to jump the snap count.
Right, and he just stepped a little over. But that's he hasn't played defense much.
You haven't seen him on defense as much. Definitely not. As that's going to bring the Coyotes forward about 5 yards there.
5 yards, yeah.
As, once again, we can see three receivers out to the right. Maybe a handoff here, we'll see. It is a handoff there to Danny Washington. He's trying to find the hole and brought down after a while by three different Warriors.
Number 17, Jacob G.
And Cameron Baker there bringing Danny Washington down. Now, the Coyotes at the 24-yard line, second and two here.
And that was Trent Palmer who helped him out with that tackle.
As you haven't seen that many like under center formations. I don't think we've seen any under center formations at all, keeping the offense versatile here with the pass and run game.
Mm-mm.
As maybe a blitz coming here from Troy Tripps, right? And once again another handoff here to Danny Washington, who just trugs forward, no response here, constantly getting 6-7 yards in these inside zones.
We have to, the Warriors have to put Caleb Quiros, the big guy, against the big guy.
They need to load the box here.
Yeah, they do.
As Coyotes are trucking down this field, no problem. Although not being as flashy as that one Warriors drive. As
long as it gets the job done, actually. Yeah. I don't think it has to be flashy as long as it just gets the job done.
A fumbled snap here. Number 15 picks it back up. Quarterback rolling out right, maybe not going for a scramble.
Flag in the back by the 25-yard line. 35, sorry.
That's Zacio and Saxton, once again, the quarterback. Great improvisation there by Saxton. Let's see what the flag is here. We'll see. Holding. There, so that's
offense.
Holding offense. So that's going to move the Coyotes back. We have. So now it's first and 21 here at the 27-yard line. Long ways to go. Trips to the left. It's empty backfield here for Saxton. Danny Washington in motion. Makes it four series out to left. Another fumbled snap. I don't know what's going on with the center. He just smartly takes a kneel. That's going to make it second and a mile. All of a sudden, this drive has halted because of the center. Let's see if we can get a number on him.
The freshman actually made a good play there.
Zach smartly took the kneel, trying to avoid a fumble. Smart play there by by Saxton, the quarterback.
The center seems to be having a little bit of trouble.
A little difficulties here.
Yeah.
That's two plays in a row, back-to-back with bad snaps.
We got number 15 in the back. Switching up. Okay, there it is.
Trips left, Saxton and Washington in the backfield. Let's see if the center can get a better snap this time. Washington out. And a flag. False start here on the offense.
Now that's a mile.
Second and 39 now for these Coyotes.
All right, what are we looking? Call your bets now. Hail Mary.
Keep in mind, the first down line is at the 7-yard line. They are on the 47. This is a wild field position here. As we'll see what the play call is. I'd be incredibly surprised if they go with a run. Definitely.
No way.
There's no way they would go with a run here. Maybe, they send Danny Washington out wide. This is the third
same
time
play.
They've done it. Same play. Let's see.
Saxton
rolling out, and he finds a receiver there open along the sidelines.
Charles Lynn was just not fast enough to get there. He almost had him. He almost tripped him up with the ankle pick, and he
tackled
just could not get
Hayden it. Sanchez. good throw, good catch on the run. This guy Saxton, he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, this for a freshman, that is great.
Indeed.
He must have played while he was in while he was like 7.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that little flag football league.
Looking like a veteran out there, actually.
Yeah, looking in a certain QB on the Troy side.
As we see 5 wide once again. A quick throw there this time to, and he, number 4 there on the
coyote. He's still going.
He's still going.
And he is finally pushed out of bounds by basically the whole defensive line.
Hakeem Frampton, another freshman. There's a lot of freshmen on this Coyote squad.
You know what? I don't think I'm going to trash too much on the Coyote offense because they are a young team, and young teams need time to develop and grow, and that's why we see so many open doors being closed.
Definitely. But here we see Trips right once again, number 8, jumping. Maybe signaling there. That's Anthony Irons. Let's see what's his route. He's looking downfield, looking towards the end zone. Maybe that's a chance to be picked off. Ooh.
That is out of bounds and incomplete.
Incomplete. Anthony Irons got a hand on it. Definitely could not have come down with that ball. Now it's going to set up fourth down here.
I don't know. I don't think they can kick it that far into a field goal. But I could be surprised.
That was a turnover on down, sorry.
Oh.
They were kind of in no man's land. They definitely couldn't punt there, but they didn't feel comfortable kicking the field goal. Nakamura is here on the commentator side.
And it's not too dangerous of a position to give up. Yeah. They're at the 20-yard line. That's basically just a fair catch if they were to punt it.
Yeah. Where's offense taking the field once again?
See number 8 there, Anthony Irons on defense.
Let's see what they decide. Pass here, Vander Ploeg just sits down and catches it on the curl. Good delivery. And
flag.
Still up. Took about the whole Coyotes defense to bring him down. Let's see what the flag is.
I didn't see anything, actually.
I didn't see anything. It's very obvious. Let's see what the call is here.
Pass interference, offense.
Pass interference on Vander Ploeg.
He pushed
him off there, I guess, on the curl. That's maybe how he got so much separation.
Huh. I didn't see that.
A little push off there as Vander's protesting there to the ref. That's going to send the Warriors back 10 yards.
They're basically on the 1-yard line. I think they are on the 1-yard line, actually.
They're on the 9-yard line.
Oh, never mind. Sorry about that.
Let's see. I think they have to go with a pass here, as we see a lot of players in motion. Declan Healy.
They have to. They're first and 19.
They hand the ball off here this time to Caleb Huss, who goes for about 4 yards.
He's wrapped up by Jacob Taylor.
Well, that's going to set up second and long. This is definitely a pass down.
Yeah, they have to. There's no other choice.
You don't want to run, get potentially stuffed.
I mean, I'm not doubting Declan Healy's ability to run the ball down, but.
But this is most definitely a passing down.
Yeah, this is second and 14. I don't think I'd put my the ball in the hands of a RB.
Yeah, as we see Josh King talking to Rudy Alcala there before going to the huddle.
Josh King being one of the members here at
Omnia.
Right.
Playing here. You see Declan Healy and Vander Ploeg line up on the same side. That's going to attract a lot of attention for the defense. You see a quick throw this time to Vander Ploeg, the wide receiver screen, and he's going to be brought down once again by the entire Coyotes defense. He has this wonderful ability to just stay up, refuses to go down, but doesn't really do much. That sets up third and 14 now.
I don't know how he does that. He just stays up. He doesn't go down. That's crazy.
That's going to set up third and 9, sorry. Now they're basically at the line of scrimmage once again.
Here we are. 4 minutes left on the clock.
3rd and 9. This is, as we see, Rudy Alcala looking to throw. He throws it short to Ethan Munt, who's going down. A lot of green grass in front of him. and he's eventually wrapped up by four or five Coyotes. You saw like a short kind of wide receiver screen kind of action there. Picks up there we around go. 20 yards on that. Definitely enough for the first down.
And here we are, we're talking about Ethan Munn replacing
Caleb
Huss. And I think he's certainly proven that he should be in that position.
Definitely wants his utilization, as we see this time. The handoff here to Declan Healy, that goes up the middle for about 7 yards.
And we'd like to acknowledge our amazing sponsors for this season. When you get the chance, please come check out their banners hanging up by the front entrance.
Six yards the gain, second and four on the 43-yard line with around 3 minutes left to go here in this first quarter.
There we see the defense line being shown.
Tight formation here, no one out wide, and refs calling for something. Let's see what it is.
A wardrobe malfunction. That's interesting.
Now it's being number 33 who had something wrong with his jersey, maybe. That being Leonardo Martinez for the Coyotes. As we see a handoff this time to Ethan Munn, who goes up the middle, breaks a tackle, and goes enough for the first down and more. He's brought down around the 49-yard line, but Ethan Munn,
he's being utilized so well.
He's being utilized so well. Always breaks that first tackle, looking like he got freight train on that.
Yeah. We'd also like to mention Rembrandt's Kitchen and Bar, your place for specialty steaks, fresh seafood, live entertainment, and local sports. If it's happening, it's happening here.
As we see another play being ran here, another run wrapped up there.
Probably good about 5 yards.
Warriors
by Caleb Huss.
Caleb Huss that time. Warriors trotting up this field somewhat easily. Let's see if they continue with the run game now. See the huddle there. As we see another quick snap there, and Ethan Munt that time brought down maybe for a gain of one. Gain of two there on the play. Something that I'm noticing about these Warriors is that the second they get to the line, they just snap it. They don't wait at all.
Yeah, I think they should take their time on this because as a team, you need to set up your nerves, you know, your mindset.
That was Kaiden Ordonez on the last play. And we see another run this time by
Declan
Healy.
And there is a flag on the play in the backfield.
I commend Healy for that. Just followed his blockers as we get the replay here. Yeah, he's just like jogging down the field, but just following the blockers. Good for
that's definitely what you need in an offensive line. You need those blockers to clear that way. You know, they're the truck loaders that just
second level.
Boom, right down, right wherever the RB needs to run. They're just clear the way, clear the path.
Hasn't even been the end of that first quarter yet. We've seen so many flags already. Hopefully that doesn't continue for the rest of this game.
Personal foul.
Face mask
by all the offense.
Face mask on the offense. That's going to bring the offense back. 15 yards set up, third and 21.
You know, I may not understand the physicalities of football, but because I'm not a football player myself, but I don't think it's too hard to not grab somebody else's face mask. You know what I mean?
Especially on offense, you don't even need to tackle. As we see, whistle's blown once again. Is there a timeout call? Timeout Coyotes here. That's going to be the first one of the game here on a 3rd and 17.
Interesting to use their first timeout in the first quarter of the game. 1 minute left. A minute and 30 left.
Maybe they want a game plan here for this 3rd and 17, although I don't know how much game plan they need. 3rd and 17, after all, just don't let them get the first.
Right now, I think they need to look for those interceptions, those pick sixes, you know what I mean? There we see number 33, Leonardo Martinez, the MLB, 6'2", junior, 210.
See Vander Plug there in the huddle. We've been talking about him every game. Man.
How can you not talk about Vander Plug? Standing at 6'6", making all kinds of great plays.
You notice all the warrior pink, all the student section's pink. It's pink out in support for breast cancer awareness this week.
I've got my own little pink bandana on my knee right now.
Wearing pink up here in the press box. As we see a play action, Rudy O'Connell looking deep for Vander Plug. It's going to be intercepted here. And he's still going. Maybe the whistles are being blown. We had a little bet before the game over unders 0.5 interceptions. I called the under. Ian hit the over. Ian wins that one. But
I can always, always expect something going on from Rudy.
But honestly, a wild throw here from Rudy Alcala. Throwing into double coverage, inaccurate.
I think his
mindset's just screwed. Vander's down there somewhere.
Yeah, Vander is probably pretty disappointed from his quarterback.
If it's not open, don't throw the ball.
Right.
It doesn't matter that he's 6'6". He can't come down with every ball if you throw it straight to the defense.
Yeah, exactly. He hit him right in the numbers. And by him, I mean the Coyote defense.
I don't even know who intercepted that ball.
No, neither do I, actually.
So Ian was too busy celebrating his hit on that bat there.
How can you not, honestly?
You see, third receiver's out to the left, and a handoff this time to a shifty running back.
He
looks so
quick.
He was
lightning fast, and we have a flag on the play.
Guess what? Another flag. That was Jaden Moore, the 5'11 senior. He looks so fast and shifty from up here.
Oh my gosh, he's weighing 180 and moving that fast? That is crazy.
Absolutely wild, man. Refs sharing their dirty laundry so much this game.
Let's see what the goal is.
Personal foul. Horse collar tackle there. Ooh. So that's going to.
That's against the defense.
That's going to bring the guys even farther. But that's such a killer to this morale. They just came off a touchdown from Declan Healy. It forced a turnover on downs. Driving down the field, and then Rudy O'Connell gives it in a gift draft box to the defense that time.
I was really hoping I didn't win that bet, by the way, for all you watching at home and for the football players who will watch this later on.
As you see Saxton here hand the ball off once again to Jaden Moore, who goes nowhere. That's going to be 2nd and 10. Pick of a vote. The refs give him 4 progress generously for 1 yard.
That is very generous, actually. This is the same lightning fast Jaden Moore that we saw earlier, who ran up the field in the quickest amount of time that I've ever seen in a high school player. We've got a lively crowd down here. Even if it's Gunpowder Park, we still have a great student section, all in pink.
It's our senior night. Everyone's coming out to support. As you see, Paxton, quick throw there to number 8, being Anthony Irons once again, brought down there by Jacob Warner. Jacob Warner, if you recall, had the game-winning block kick last game against Fullerton. The score was 34-35, with Fullerton having 34 and trying to kick the extra point. Jacob Warner comes off the edge and blocks the kick, giving us the ball back with under a minute left, up by 1, seal the game against the Indians there last week, or 2 weeks ago. As let's see what the guys are cooking up here. 2 receivers to the right, 2 to the left.
First and 10.
What do you know?
It's the end of the first. 7-0 Troy. This first quarter has certainly brought a lot of yellow into the green field.
Did a lot from the second play of the game. A Declan Healy touchdown, turnover down, interception. We've seen a lot in this first quarter alone.
It's been pretty exciting. It's been fun.
Interesting to see how this one plays out.
Right now, the Troy Warriors are standing at 2-0 in their league wins.
And Boyner Park being 0-2. Let's see what those records change.
By the looks of it, no. But if Rudy keeps throwing those kind of balls, then...
Cleveland Warrior. fans in attendance, you can still show your warrior pride. ASB is restocked Spiritwear with additional sizes. You can come and get it here right now as the first quarter came to an end. Once again, we'd like to thank one of our sponsors, Boost Clubs, asked us to mention the wonderful sponsors for this year. Sleep like a warrior. Head over to Custom Comfort Mattresses for your mattress needs. We're committed to handcraft quality with natural materials for your best sleep. I don't know. Reading about that commercial, reminds me of that Sleep Number commercial with Dak Prescott.
Right.
As we're going to see the Coyotes offense take the field once again here.
Certainly see some Dak Prescott attributes in this game.
And off once again there to number two, Jaden Moore. And still not brought down. Eventually gets brought down there. Looks like he wanted to go for more.
Number 43 was the one who shoved him out of the play. You always love to see a little scramble between two players. Second and 8 here. He looks right. He's in trouble. He's rolling right. He throws right. And it is almost intercepted, and it is incomplete. There you say he has to roll right, number 15. He throws it all the way down to the right, and it is incomplete. Here we are at 3rd and 8 now. 11 minutes on the clock of the second quarter. I'm not sure if he really needed to do that. I think he had some tight ends that were a little short that he could have passed to, but he looked for the long ball on the right-hand side, and he didn't get it.
Big risk, big reward. Almost intercepted that time. Let's see what they come up with here on this 3rd and 8. Looking to throw pressure in his face as it's
caught.
They're caught there, surprisingly, by a Coyote.
That number 11, Raheem Moorhead.
Raheem Moorhead. That looked like it was undercut, but there's a flag on the play. The yardage seems to still stand. The flag was on the Warriors.
Yeah, I think it's being taken back.
And gonna bring the Coyotes forward.
Oh, never mind. I don't know what that call was for. Oh, let's see. Personal foul.
Roughing the passer, that Ooh. Was. There was three guys in his face there.
I don't think that was roughing the passer, honestly. But, you know, whatever the ref sees, the ref
brings
sees.
Brings the Coyotes all the way up to the 12-yard line. Or, sorry, 8-yard line.
Eight.
We see three receivers bunched up there on the far right. Let's see. Maybe if they...
I'm thinking a quick pass.
Quick pass. Maybe even a quick run here to Jaden Moore. Let's see. An outside zone, maybe. Let's see. And it is a quick handoff there to Jaden Moore. He's trying to truck forward for some yards.
And he is stopped by the entire defensive line of the Warriors.
Like to see them stuff that stuff the front there. Seen so many inside runs go for like 7-8 yards. Good to see one.
Yeah, they
top one.
Yeah, I mean they've been doing good on this Buena Park Coyote offense on the run game.
Definitely.
That's a good shot.
Interesting. That shoulder camera there
by Adam. Good job, Adam.
See two receivers. To the right, we see number 5, Danny Washington, in motion. Another quick handoff here to Jaden Moore. Let's see if he can cut up field.
And he is wrapped up from behind.
Wrapped around the 3-yard line there. That's going to bring up.
I believe that was Tommy Inu who made the tackle.
Bring up 3rd and goal from the 4 now.
There we see the center, number 55, Jesus Sandoval. He's been a little jumpy that first quarter, huh?
Yeah.
Let's see.
how the Coyotes will act unless they're down. Yet another handoff to Jayden Moore. Breaks, strips off one defender, maybe got to the 1 yard line. That's going to bring a fourth and down. That's an interesting perspective. You could very easily kick this field goal and pretty much guaranteed to go through. Shorter than an extra point, but it's only 1 yard
right.
to tie up the game.
Even a QB sneak would work.
Let's see if we see a little Eagles tush push here.
Eagles tush push, yeah. Jalen Hurts
Jalen
with his
Hurts,
famous QB sneak. Almost infamous. We see number 15.
Maybe I think they might just hand this ball off once again. I'd be surprised if they pass. It is a possibility, but I'm loading the box. Yep, they hand it off to Jayden Moore. Let's
and he
see.
Is stopped.
And he is stopped. Once again, a turnover that throws Jayden Moore back to where he came from. Turnover on downs once again by this Warriors defense. They've been amazing this first half.
Absolutely trucked and thrown to the ground like a wrestler.
And the Warriors offense will take the field once again. Let's see if we can get something this drive.
You know what? Really, I'm hoping that we will. But it is pretty bad field position.
The ball's on a 3 yard line here.
Maybe we can look for a run pass. Or, I mean, a run play by Ethan Munt.
We see a Declan Healy going out to the edge, cuts back inside, still
cuts
on
outside,
his feet, and he's,
and he's
cuts
running.
Outside, he's running.
Number eight,
Anthony
Irons,
and he pushes up. He stays in bounds. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Warriors. 97 yards on the first carry. Cuts back inside, cuts outside, cuts back inside. 1 minute beats a foot race. Anthony Irons trying to push him out. Declan Healy wonderfully, masterfully stays in bounds. That's his second touchdown of the game. What a play by Declan Healy.
Oh, my gosh. That was exhilarating.
We get a replay. He seems to stay in bounds.
Irons says that he was out of bounds. Irons was definitely looking at it.
Are they calling this back? Oh, they are called boo. They're calling this all the way back. Oh.
Why?
Maybe an illegal block in the back. Oh, that's so disappointing for the Warriors.
It's disappointing for me. I thought maybe they would have called it at like the 50-yard line.
I thought maybe they pushed him out of bounds, but
right.
No, it's a flag that brings it all the way back.
What was the flag for?
We'll see shortly here, but that call met with tons of boos and discomfort here by this crowd, including coming from me.
Yeah, that is definitely disappointing to see. We thought we were going to be 14-0.
Let's see what the call is here, if they're going to announce it soon.
I couldn't see it. He announced it, but I couldn't see it. Block in the back?
Illegal block in the back, but they put the ball in the I'm very perplexed.
Me
here.
Too.
If
this is one of those,
there's a flag for illegal block in the back, how are they still going to pick up a 6? I don't exactly know. Maybe it's 10 yards from the spot, but timeout Warriors.
I would definitely need to regroup after that. I mean, you must be feeling very
just disappointed.
Right, disappointed. Like, you were so hyped up. You saw Declan Healy running down inside, then out, then onto the sideline. And then I thought he was going to get pushed out, but he was able to get his feet in the line. Then you see right there, Irons. He thought he pushed him out of bounds. He even pointed. He was like, I got him right there. But turns out he didn't. And then it was all blown up by it.
The refs are just having a talk here. They've been doing that a lot this game. This is a ref showcase or a football game? I can't tell at this
neither
point.
Neither
can I. So many flags. What exactly the refs are talking about, don't know.
We can almost compare it to the week one.
Valley game.
Yeah, where it was a random turnover to the Barons.
Turnover. Eventually got clarification after. It was bad on the refs part. They overturned the play. That was one play old, which you are not allowed to do.
No.
But that's week one.
Yeah.
Can't change anything about it now.
Why are we looking at week one right now?
Let's see. You know, I'd hand it off to Declan Healy on a motion here. Maybe go to the left side. But they hand it up the middle. He has a lot of space, that being Ethan Munt. Going up the... Got to the second level pretty easily. Pickup of 12 there that time. That's going to move the chains. Bring up a new set of downs.
Ethan Munt has been, again, the key factor in this whole thing. He definitely got them out of a tight situation at the one-yard line, and now he's brought them all the way up here.
See a tight formation here. Another motion. And play action. He's sacked! Rudy Alcala from his blind side. That's going to be number 33, Leonardo Martinez, the 6'2", 210 junior. Completely unblocked. Rudy Alcala didn't see him coming.
Came in like a truck. I don't think I've ever seen Rudy sacked before, actually. It's quite the shock to me.
He's been sacked a couple times, but that time, he had no idea he was coming.
I had no idea he was coming.
Couldn't even evade the pressure.
He was there in a blink of an eye.
So that's going to set up second and 18 here on the 15-yard line. Not a good position to be in if you're Troy, from what you just thought was a touchdown to now.
But hey, we saw Buena Park be able to get out of the same situation.
Handoff this time, once again, up the middle. No answer. That's going to be, guess what, Ethan Munt once again. That's going to be 10 yards officially. That's going to bring up 3rd and 8.
Now we're in pretty good position. I'm not liking the downs, but we take what we get, right?
3rd and long here. See what they'll.
It's definitely better than 3rd and 15.
3rd and 50, yeah. And we're going to see a pass here deep to Declan Healy, who may have had maybe a half foot of separation, but overthrown slightly there. That's going to be on 4th and 8.
We don't see many long balls incomplete by Rudy Alcala.
And
it's usually the short passes.
Chavez is keeping the offense out on the field. 4th and 8 on the 25-yard line. If they don't get this, the Coyotes are on a – oh, and nope, he's bringing the punt team out.
Okay, yeah, good idea.
I saw Chavez, like, make a hand sign to tell the offense to stay out on the field. Maybe he's trying to fake out that Coyote defense, make them unprepared for this punt return. The punt there by Vander going sky high.
Illegal block in the back. God, by number 5, Danny Washington. I saw that clear as day, but apparently the refs did not. What? Did you see that somehow?
I saw a player from Warrior just tumbling down.
Right, because he got shoved in the back.
Huh.
Where's the flag on that, refs?
Just a fair catch there. 3 Warriors were coming out the returner. Didn't decide to return. That's going to.
Fair catch, yeah. That wasn't very fair.
It should be 10 yards back, as you see the Coyote sideline here. And the chain crew.
We have a very lively crowd over here on the Troy side. It's always fun to hear the crowd.
The environment.
Right.
Especially on those big plays, those big third downs.
The big bombs thrown.
Yeah. You see 4 receivers out to the right. I'm thinking this is just a quick screen pass. That's what I would be prepared for if I'm Troy. Danny Washington motioned out wide.
Oh, and he was about to. He's scrambling.
About to scrambled up and
he slides.
Flag here this time. So many flags.
I can't even say. You know what? Never mind.
There's so many flags this game. This game's going to go on forever at this rate.
We'll never get out of here at this rate. That's what.
It's been an hour and 46 minutes, and we're not even at halftime yet.
Holding Coyotes.
Just 46 minutes.
Offense getting pushed back 15 yards. We'd love to see it. If you're a Troy Warrior, of course. If you're a Buena Park Coyote, I'm not sure about that.
It's going to bring up 1st and 20 here.
roundabout. That was interesting. Oh, and he's wrapped up by number 15. That is Ethan Munt.
Ethan Munt, that's on defense.
Yeah, he kind of bent his back like a scorpion. That looked like it hurt. I've experienced that kind of injury, and I'll tell you, it's not fun. It lasts for a long time.
See what the Coyotes come up here on the 2nd and 13. Definitely want to make this a more manageable third down. Try to get the first down here, actually. See what Saxton has and the offense has in mind. See two running backs, and now one, number 21, motioned out. Play action, number 10 is wide open down the seam.
And he drops it. Butterfingers.
Aaron Rodriguez, the senior wide receiver, streaking down the seam there, wide open. Ball plays almost perfectly.
Yeah, that was really, it was a good pass.
This is dropped.
Bad reception. Must have eaten some popcorn before. Maybe a little toast, because there was a lot of butter on it.
That's 3rd and 14 now here for the Warriors. Or, sorry, for the Coyotes. That's a tough position to be in, but let's see what...
They've gotten out of worse.
Definitely, as we see number eight, Anthony Irons in motion here. Saxton dropping back to throw, throws it deep. He has separation, and it's
overthrown
this time. That was number four. Forward, Hakeem Frampton, the freshman wide receiver, streaking down the right sideline, darting down the right sideline. The speed was showing. Absolutely toasted his man.
Just two, actually. There was two men on him.
He toasted the safety help over the top, which is wild. Just overthrown there a little bit by Saxton. That's going to be on 4th and 14. Definitely going to see a punt here. See a good punt. A short. And Declan Healy just calls for it. Not. And that's going to be touched at around the 32-yard line. So that's where the Warriors are going to start this drive. 5:43 left in this second quarter.
It's definitely been a very interesting first half. We've seen interceptions. We've seen second play touchdowns, sacks, which we normally really don't see unless you're Charles Lynn.
Keep an eye out for the halftime activities for the senior night. We're going to see Troy Warrior Band and Troy Cheer and Red Hots and All Male performing here at halftime. As you see, handoff going up the middle there.
Not much.
Both sides pushing either way. Trying to get those few extra yards. Ethan Munt there on the carry. Goes for about 6 yards.
Ethan Munt is now going off into the sidelines.
2nd and 4.
There he is. Ethan Munt. Man with the legend.
I think this calls for a passing down. I think we might see a play action or just a normal handoff. And we see a handoff going up the middle. Some open space there by Caleb Huss. Dragged down around the 50-yard line.
Caleb Huss has great acceleration, as we just saw there.
Just saw him explode through the hole there. Great carry there by Caleb Huss. Great push there from the offensive line.
Ethan Munt now come back on the field, along with Vander Ploeg, who's a little confused on where he should be, but that's okay.
Let's see what the Warriors do now. I kind of want to see a pass.
Me too. I want to see a long
pass.
See
another handoff here to Caleb Huss, who's going up as we see that acceleration.
Ooh,
I talked about playing once
there.
Again.
That was nice and smooth.
He sees exactly where he wants to go, accelerates towards it, pick up a 5 there on that play, 2nd and 5 at the 44-yard line.
Caleb Huss being the junior, 5'7", 170 pounds. moving really fast for 170 pounds, if I say so.
You see, once again, another handoff here to Caleb Huss. Three plays in a row, and he's going
Juke's
up.
Juke's right.
He has a lot of open field, one man to beat. Let's see if
Stiff
Anthony
arm,
Irons
come on.
Brings him. Ooh. Anthony Irons there brings Caleb Huss on the long run around the 6-yard line, virtually untouched until the end there. Man. Great blocking we're seeing from this Warriors offense. Let's get a replay of it here. Tries for the stiff arm. Couldn't exactly get it, but great run there. It brings up first and goal at the 6-yard line.
That's a Caleb Huss I remember. Those first few weeks back here.
Right.
He wants his spot. He has to fight for it against Ethan Munt.
I don't know if they're fighting over it, but let's see. And we see another handoff this time to Ethan Munt.
Not much.
Maybe a yard or two there on the play. Now Ethan Munt, Caleb Huss. Even Declan Healy, we see three great running back options here for the Warriors, two of them being seniors.
And we haven't seen much from Vander Ploeg at all.
We saw that one reception that was called back because of the push-off.
Right, but before and after that, there's not been much for Vander Ploeg.
We saw a lot of him early on to the season. They started to come out of that pass-heavy offense and more into the run and Ethan Munt more later throughout this year. Another Warriors timeout. That's going to be their second, only leaving them one left with 3:18 left in this first half of play. See the Warriors are in that hole. Second and five, or second and goal here. What do you think the Warriors are going to do? Second and five, second and goal.
I'm not sure. I would look for probably Vander Ploeg.
On a fade route?
He's pretty known for catching in the corner.
Maybe even get a pass interference call here.
Yeah, we saw a lot of those in week one. Or was it week two? I can't remember. I think it was a rush right up the middle. Oh.
And that's going to bring them down to the 1-yard line. That's Ethan Munt once again. 1-yard line, third and one. Anticipating a touchdown here. 3 minutes and taking down here.
What do we think? They're going to get
it? Push?
Tush push? I would want to see a touch push. Honestly, I really would.
I think what would be a fun call would be like put Ethan Munt under center. And we're going to see Rudy Alcala again trying to QB sneak his way into the end zone. Did he get it? Let's see what the official call is here. No whistle, no signal. Warriors signaling for touchdown.
I think it's a stoppage.
If this is fourth down, I'm going for it.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Rudy Alcala on the QB sneak. That's something we said often, touchdown, a rushing touchdown for Rudy Alcala.
Yeah, that's not often, honestly. Kind of hoping for a graphic there.
As Caleb Huss here for the extra point to make it a 14-0 lead.
Caleb Huss, who took over the spot of Hayden Sanchez of kicker.
Up and through. So that's going to make the lead 14-0, 2:26 left in this first half. On that 1-yard touchdown, QB sneak by Rudy Alcala.
You called it so long. You said, tush push. And I think they heard you because that's what they went for. I don't think we've seen a tush push yet from the Warriors.
We haven't really seen a situation which it would be needed in.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. Caleb Huss back to kick. We got once again. We can hear some of the crowd
just playing in. Just a great experience here.
Very lively, very fun, family friendly.
Caleb Huss back here for the kickoff. Three Coyotes at the 10-yard line. ready to receive.
A little stomp is interesting. Kind of funny.
Maybe like an intimidation tactic.
Yeah. I like Fountain Valley's. Those are fun. That little swing.
Yeah. Kickoff is underway. It's fielded around the 9-yard line. He's going to see he's going up to the middle, and he's brought down there shortly. A fumble on the play.
The Warriors are calling it their ball.
The Warriors are saying it's their ball. Who's got it? Let's get to the bottom of the pile.
Trent Palmer, very, very enthusiastic about it.
And it is Warrior ball. So with 2:21, the Warriors have the ball now at the Coyotes' 24-yard line.
That is crazy. I wasn't expecting that at all. There you see number 25, Dylan Lim.
Saw the whole bench just jump up and down there soon as the signal came through. That was a Warrior ball. So
also saw Derek Rubikava.
You see the Warriors take over on the 25-yard line. I want to see a 25-yard touchdown reception by Vander Ploeg. He is looking to be on one-on-one coverage. Maybe some safety help there by Anthony Irons over the top.
Yeah.
But we see a run.
And it is smothered. I really want to see Vander in action. I have not seen Vander in action, and I am displeased.
Hakeem Frampton is a 5'10 freshman guarding a 6'6 Vander Ploeg. Now that is 8 inches of height difference.
That's incredibly
It doesn't.
He should be throwing
a Rudy. Vander said something to Rudy there. Maybe that's what we're going to see on this play.
Hopefully.
They know not to press him up. We see Hakeem Frampton being 10 yards off the line. See ya.
And he's looking Vander, right. He's looking at Vander. Oh, no.
He tucks it down this time to Caleb Huss. Oh. They're brought down from behind around
that
the 10-yard line there by
that is
number
a great
seven,
tackle.
Diego Reyes. The 6'1", 175 senior.
He came in real hot. Yeah,
from behind. Great tackle there. But
props to him.
We're in great position to score here. If I'm Coach Chavez or if I'm the offense coordinator, I want to chew this clock as low as we can and then score. You see Caleb Huss off, Ethan Munt on.
You know, I like how when we saw him throw to the right, we thought it was going to be Vander, and then when it wasn't, we said, aw.
That's a bit of a disappointment, but we got a lot of yards on the play as we see a handoff up the middle. Ethan Munt.
And he's pushed back.
They're going to give him forward progress on that, probably around the 5-yard line.
And he thought he had the the strip, but he didn't. That was number seven, Diego Reyes, again.
Once again. Seen a lot of good tackles from him.
Yeah. Thought he stripped the ball, but.
Screaming up second and goal from the 5-yard line.
Man, you. Ploeg lining up on the left.
What you see is that they have it, and they're going to hand it off, and it is up the middle. Touchdown, Ethan Munt. Or
Declan Healy.
Sorry, Declan Healy, touchdown.
That's his third touchdown of the night.
Second touchdown of the night. Remember, someone got called that.
Sounds like some people dying down there.
Great reaction here for the crowd. But short, quick touchdown there, 5 yards for Declan Healy. Follow the blockers. Now we can see an extra point here, Caleb Huss, which is up and good. Declan Healy does a great job at following his blockers.
And the holder, let's give props to the holder. We never get props to the holder. That is Andrew Acuna. Play by Declan Healy. Third touchdown of the night. All run plays, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're seeing him more, and he's taking a seat there on the Warrior bench after a grueling drive.
Well,
not really that grueling. Well, it was back-to-back drives, really.
Yeah.
A whole drive down the field, then they got the fumble, and then another drive. The Warriors offense must be gassed. Let's see if they get another fumble here.
Hard work pays off, though.
Definitely.
Number 9, Caleb Huss for the kickoff.
36 seconds left in this half. We have a commanding 21-0 lead. Dare I say comfortable, as you can see a squib kick this time, trying to chew some clock. Fielded there around the 14-yard line. He's wrapped up and brought down around the 33-yard line.
I don't know about you, but I saw a little heat between number 21 and 40 of the Buena Park Coyotes.
Let's see.
Oh, is there a flag on the play?
I don't see any yellow. Maybe they picked it up. There's just some confusion going on by the refs here.
Yeah, there's a flag that the head ref is picking it up now. Putting it in his pocket.
Let's see what the call is. Let's see a sportsmanlike conduct called here. That's not something we see very often. Unsportsmanlike conduct.
Maybe he was talking about the guy that I saw. Number 40 and number 21 kind of scrapping.
A little bit of extracurricular activity after the play there. That's going to set them up at the 17-yard line as you see a handoff here this time to Danny Washington, who's going up the field. Sorry, that was Anthony Irons actually carrying the ball.
Tackle made by Hayden Sanchez.
12-yard gain, good enough for a first down. That's going to be probably the last play of this first half as
6 seconds left,
six
though.
6 seconds, the clock is stopped.
Let's see a Hail Mary. How about that?
Died. See? The Coyotes called a timeout.
Yeah, they did.
With 6 seconds left at their own 29-yard line.
Hail Mary. Come on, Hail Mary. Give me it.
A Hail Mary is going to go to the 40-yard line. Maybe some laterals here. That'd be fun to watch.
It would be.
Hey,
I would love to see that.
October, Friday the 13th. A little bit of trickery, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Be a bit fun. I mean, they're almost in desperation mode here. 21-0.
Yeah. Hey, I see a ref with a little pink on his wrist. That's cool. I've never seen that before. Oh, they all do.
They all do. The Warriors wearing pink numbers. That's not our shading.
Numbers are red, but the socks are pink.
As we see
a little review, see Vanderklue, Caleb Huss,
a lot of Warriors there,
DJ,
Andrew Acuna. We've seen how they can improve from that last drive. See two shooters to the left, two to the right.
Come on, give me some lats.
Laterals, let's see. See a bunch of Warrior DBs way back, 20, 30 yards.
Am I right? Come on, tell me I'm right. 9 seconds left on the clock. This will be the last play of the first half.
Yeah,
motion.
Just a handoff to Washington. Let's see how he goes. Trying to hurdle there and gets absolutely picked up and thrown out of bounds.
I appreciate the effort. Yeah.
That was funny. So that's going to be the last play of the first half.
Definitely an exciting first half.
21-0. It's definitely exciting for Troy. I don't imagine the Warriors talking about much during this halftime.
Right.
Oh, they call 1 second left on the clock.
Why is there 1 second left on the clock? What am I going to do with that 1 second? Now some laughs? Yeah, maybe. That would be fun.
It'd be fun to see some ladders. Maybe a fumble lateral return touchdown.
That's a lot. That's a lot to ask for.
Last word. But I think lateral is very risky. Come on, let's see a Hail Mary.
Yeah, we already see a tush push. Now, come on, let's see a Hail Mary. We are at 33. 1 second left on the clock. Coyote offense is really—they're really trying to see what they can pull out of the whole playbook.
Let's see. 1 second. Not really much to see.
No, there shouldn't be much to see. But hey, we could be wrong. There could be a Hail Mary and a touchdown.
We saw a last-second touchdown against Fountain Valley, a throw to Vander Ploeg in the front right corner of the end zone.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. I think we should put Vander Ploeg out there as safety. That'd be funny.
We
see pure Hail Mary here. Saxton rolling out right, throwing it deep to number 11, and he's going to get tackled.
Are you still up?
Just a little bit.
Oh, and there he goes.
Just a little bit of stat padding there at the end of the first half.
Tackle made by Trent Palmer, number 6. Ooh, and a little, little heat.
The game cannot end up, the half cannot end on a penalty, so if they throw the flag, which they're not going to do, thankfully.
Yeah, that was number 11, Raheem Moorhead, who made the catch. Enough.
Warriors already walking out, walking to their locker room. 21-0 at the end of this first half. Nah, I can't imagine they would be talking about much in that locker room. Buena Park, they'd be seeing how to stop this amazing run game that the Warriors have.
I mean, is it really a surprise? We kind of called it the beginning of the first half. They weren't gonna put too much of a fight. Right now, we're about to see
half-time
the Red Hots and All Mayo.
We're gonna see Troy's dancing, Red Hots, All Mayo, as well as Troy's marching band. Stay tuned for halftime, folks.
I'd like to recognize and acknowledge some of our seniors in our marching band. And the Noah Aguirre, Joshua Falco, Renee Chen, John Troy, Andres Cordova, Raymond Scully, Amanda Hong, Raniel Fuller, Christine Dion, Isaac Kim, Rachel Kim, Andrew Lee, Jake Lee, Ethan Lauren Bao, James Lopez, Nikolai Matias, William Matthews, Martin Orea, Andy Castellana. Zillian Patel, Justin Rivera, William Welby, Marcus Moody, Joanna Thomas, Alexandra Yola, Arif Dia, Vanessa Yang, Yunu Yang, Ethan Yoon, Rella Young, Athena Aviello Garcia, Alyssa Chang Chief, and Valentina Galente. Mr. C would like to thank you for all your hard work in the past 4 years. Once again, to all of our seniors and all of our color guard and band members, I want to thank you this past season. 4 years, these last 4 years, for all your hard work. I know that you've put in a lot of it, and it's true. Good luck tomorrow in your parade, as you have the privilege to perform. Put your hands together as we begin our halftime entertainment and welcome out to the field, Troy Redhawks and first in from around the league. Over at Alejandro High School, the Raiders are hosting the Indians. Sonora Raiders, 21. Fullerton Indians, 28. From over at Boyne Park High School, Sonora Lancers, 0. Alejandro High School, 38. And the game is sold out in 3 minutes online. At halftime, St. John Bosco, 14. Modern Day, 0. Modern Day, Bosco is just now kicking off the Modern Day.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back from halftime after those amazing performances by the Troy Warriors color guard and marching band along with the dance team, Red Hots and All Male. Quick recap of the first half. Right now it is 21 Troy, Buena Park 0. We've seen 3 touchdowns. And here's a sideline interview with Coco. We are about to get a silent interview here, Coco, with Coach Bloom.
Well, I am expecting to hopefully say some more of what we just finished the ball and scoring touchdowns. But we have to go rid of that. To wait to make that.
Saw the opening kickoff of the second half, field around the 10-yard line, return to the 32. Quick recap of the first half, got a little bit interrupted there. We saw 3 touchdowns for the Warriors, 2 from Declan Healy, 1 from a QB sneak by Rudy Alcala. We also saw 197-yard touchdown get called back. Buena Park hasn't seen much success in anything, really, this whole half. They've been turned over on downs twice. Their offense seems to sputter out after a few down series.
Let's see if they can pick it up in this second half.
Oh, another fumble attempt. We saw that a lot. He flipped it to Washington, who has daylight in front of him. Great improvisation. I gotta tell you, the center of the Coyotes, he's been really shaky. Yeah. He's had like 3 bad snaps. This actually being his 4th. But what I gotta say is Saxon, the quarterback, is doing a great job at recovering. Right there, you saw he flipped it to Danny Washington, who actually gained yards. He went for a gain of 3. Really impressive there.
And it was Jesus Sandoval, the center of Buena Park Coyotes, who made that bat snap. For the 3rd time of the night?
3rd time, I think, is around.
That's very unfortunate.
As we see...
Oh,
Washington
a little flip around.
Still going.
And he's brought down.
Finally brought down. Oh, sorry. That was Saxton. We didn't really see what was going on. And Saxton just running around. Nowhere to go. Eventually brought down.
By Derek Rubalcaba, number 14.
Gain of 2 there. 3rd and 5. 33-yard line. Trips right here, empty backfield, 2 receivers to the left and to the right. Saxton drops back, looking to his right, throws the curl route short there to number 10, Aaron Rodriguez, the 6'2 senior. Caught for close to the markers. I believe they'll give him the first down here.
It was
first
a low
and
pass.
10. low pass. I think they're to mainly avoid the interception or maybe a deflection. Good throw. Good fundamental catch. They move the sticks. As we see similar formation, but trips left. See Jaden Moore in the backfield. And they actually hand it off there. That is Jerron Johnson Jr. who they handed off to. Another freshman here on the Coyotes. Seen a lot of freshman action between Saxton, Jaden Moore, who we just said.
You got to give the freshmen a lot of credit here because they're just bull rushing this Warrior defense time and time again.
Here's second and one with two receivers to the left. See Saxton there behind. Hands it off this time.
And he is wrapped up.
He's wrapped up for a gain of three. That's going to be enough for a
first down.
A nice fundamental drive so far by these Coyotes.
Yeah, it's been a lot of run plays, which has been working for them for this second start of the second half. A lot better than their first half passing game.
Yeah, definitely. We see, once again, you see two receivers to the left, and you see Irons and another running back there in the backfield. Irons motioned out to be in the slot, going up the seam. Looking left, he's pressured. Then eventually throws it to a wide open JJJ, who goes for about 20 yards there. That's Jerron Johns Jr.
Number 15, who made the tackle, Ethan Muntz.
Ethan Muntz, he's been saying his name on offense and defense.
That's very crazy. I can't believe we are saying his name on offense and defense.
We see
same thing with Caleb Huss, too. Except on special teams.
And Declan Healy, he's actually not so much this game, but he's been playing corner, sometimes safety, for a couple weeks now.
Yeah.
Let's see. We see bunch trips to the weak side of the field, and one receiver, number 11, Raheem Moorhead, lined all the way out to the left. I think this would be a handoff most likely. And low snap there. Saxton throws it to slant. Raheem Moorhead,
he's still
fighting for those extra yards. Eventually brought down around the 5-yard line.
Again by Ethan Muntz. We saw lots of tackles.
Yeah. Good stop. Good quick efficient stops after. They're not allowing much yardage after the catches.
Yeah, but they are allowing the
yards.
Yeah, they're allowing the yards.
They're allowing the catch.
Number six, Trent Palmer.
Let's see. Once again, trips left. Aaron Rodriguez, Raheem Moorhead being two, and Anthony Irons. That's a lot of talent there on that left side. Let's see what they go with. And it's going to be a play action. They're going to throw it to the slant. It's a little bit behind him, but good defense intended there that time for Hakeem Frampton.
That was by Declan Healy. We were just talking about him.
We were just talking about his impact on defense. The throw there by Saxton, a little bit behind him, hit the hands, though.
Josh King on the floor.
Maybe just stretching out a little. Let's.
Maybe a little disappointed. He doesn't look in agony, but.
Just stretching that, stretching the joints out, maybe.
Maybe. Pulled muscles are very common in sports.
Seems to be walking in the lane. As we see the same formation here, but flip, trips left, and we see number two, Jaden Moore, motioned out wide. There's a lot of pressure in his face, and it's
almost intercepted by Declan Healy.
That time by Declan Healy. Bounced off his forearm there as he tried to curl the ball in.
That was almost as if he was throwing to Declan on purpose.
Incomplete is the result. So that's going to bring up third down and goal from the 6-yard line.
Kind of expecting Declan to catch that, especially being a wide receiver. I guess he just wasn't expecting a throw right to him.
We've seen some two back-to-back not so great throws by Saxton, the quarterback, which is kind of out of his nature.
Can we see a choke coming from Saxton?
Let's see, the same formation once again. Trips left and receivers to the right. I think they should be pressing up a little bit more here. And they're going to hand it off this time to Jaden Moore, who's reaching forward.
Ethan Muntz again and Trent Palmer. Oh, Ethan Munt. Looks like he hurt his finger.
The rollover tackle there.
Yeah.
See Jade Moore falling to the beckoning to the sideline. Looking for a coach signal. See Jade Moore is walking back, telling Saxon to play here. It's going to be fourth down and six. They have to, I think this is a good call. They're down 21. They have to go for it here. We see two receivers to the right, two to the left. I highly doubt they run this ball. Let's see what Saxon. A bad snap. Worst time for a bad
and
snap.
It is
and
a sack.
Down. That is the third turnover on downs in this game, this time coming at the hands of the center, who cannot seem to get a grasp on this ball. As a former center myself, this is really disappointing to see here.
Number 15, Ethan Munt again.
With the sack there that time.
Tripped him up by the ankles.
But that's going to give the Warriors the ball on their own 14-yard line. So 86 yards to go for another score. They're just looking to chew this clock and go home. They're up 21. There's nothing flashy to do here. We're going to see a lot of Ethan Munt, Caleb Huss, maybe some Declan Healy runs here.
We need to park the bus. That's what we need to do right
yep,
now.
Yep, as we see it outside Declan Healy run. They've been so good this game.
Oh, tripped over by his own guy.
Yeah, it's tripped over Caleb Huss, who got pushed over, pushed down there. Let's see.
Right there. Oop. He's taken down by number four.
Declan Healy. Let's see. Once again, a tight formation. Definitely expecting a run. We see Mander just running around, motioning a lot here. I don't know what for. This most likely going to be a run. As we see, the motion and inside handoff. And I think that might be a horse collar tackle.
That was
and
that
the
was
one
by number 54, Danny Washington.
We've been seeing so many flags this game, but the one time I think we see an obvious horse collar tackle, there's no yellow to be seen. So that's going to bring up third and six here, which Warriors are going to might go three now, which isn't exactly terrible as they're taking a lot of time off the clock,
yeah.
But definitely not ideal.
I definitely think that should have been called.
A horse collar, yeah, definitely.
Now, did you think that the refs earned the booing of the first half? I mean, the entrance of the second half.
The refs earned the booing. With the amount of yellow we've been seeing, the crowd just does not like to see the flags. As you see, third and six, Rudy driving back to throw. A lot of pressure. We can see a screen here to Ethan Munt, who's fighting. Did he get the first down? He looks to be short, maybe 4 yards there. That's going to bring up fourth and two. That's, we saw the screen pass there.
Short, and he was brought down by number 70, Alfredo Padilla.
Definitely going to see a punt here by the Warriors. No reason to go for this when you're up 21. As, yep, we see the punt team going on. Vander going back to punt it.
A wide receiver. It's kind of weird to see a wide receiver.
Like punt?
Yeah.
Timeout Warriors here. Interesting timeout call. I don't know what they could be discussing here. I definitely don't see them going for it in this
fourth
situation.
And two?
Fourth and two is fourth and short.
But
then again, if they don't get it, they give the Coyotes such great field position, and they're already up 21. There's no reason to really risk everything.
Yeah, that's true. I would say just go for the punt. There we see number 54, Washington. Been a big name here. Playing as running back. Not running back.
That's Danny Washington, number 54.
Ooh.
Up here in the press box, this myself, so I'm Dev, here Ian Diaz. We've been pleased to be your announcers for this year. As fourth and two is now coming up here, the punt, a little bit of high snap there, punt there. Vander Ploegs, once again, another sky high punt. Rolling, number three is going to let it roll. And no,
oh,
he actually picks
no
it up.
Fair catch.
Just picks it up, gets absolutely wrapped up and pummeled there.
That was number three, Jerron Johnson Jr.
JJJ.
JJJ, yeah.
My man, Jerron Jackson Jr. with the NBA.
NBA is not my expert of
area of expertise.
Yeah, there you go.
They're going to give him a 2-yard, quote-unquote, return there. Really just wrapping the ball up, preventing it from rolling further. As can the Coyotes do? Do you think the Coyotes have a chance of digging out of this deficit of a 21-0?
I can't see it as a possible reality. I really can't. I mean,
you have 16 minutes of a game left.
Yeah, but we're talking about the Boynton Park Coyotes.
That's gonna have to be a touchdown every 5 minutes. They're gonna have to get some explosive plays, stops on defense. They have to play perfectly, more than perfect actually, from now on, if they want to have a chance at winning this game.
Here's the reality I'm seeing: a 0-3 score.
Ooh, 0-3 in league is not something you want. Where is currently our number one in league after bringing LaHabra, as we see Saxon dropping back to throw, rolling out right, hits the open receiver, but he drops it. That's Hakeem Frampton. We've been seeing a lot of butterfingers from these Coyotes.
Yeah, they must have had popcorn. I'm telling you, they must have.
Hakeem Frampton drops the pass that could have been good for about 8 yards. I gotta say, Saxton is doing a great job at improvising. Great job.
Saxton is really carrying the weight of this entire team.
He needs the support from his receivers. Making the plays, can the receivers continue? Can they complete the play? That's really what the problem is here.
It's been a very lopsided, I guess, effort from one guy, and that's Saxton, the freshman.
As we see, Saxton dropping back, and more flags being thrown on the play here. Flags there at the line of scrimmage here. Let's see, Saxton almost spiked in Saxton's face there. We see number 11, that being Raheem Moorhead, talking with the ref. Let's see what the call is here. Ref discussing.
It seems like there's some confusion going on. Holding. Offense. It was declined? Wow, interesting.
They're going to decline the penalty, so it's third down, and they take the sack as well instead of it being 2nd and 20. It could really go either way. They decide to decline to make it a 3rd and long.
Why not?
As we see, 4 receivers out to the right. If this is not a wide receiver screen to the right, I don't know what it is. Let's see if this is Prush. And another bad snap once again. Ooh.
Almost picked off by the 6'5", Trent Palmer, number 6.
He's just flinging it up just to prevent the sack there, which isn't exactly a terrible idea. But here, 4th and 11, they're punching the ball back to the Warriors. We've been seeing the same thing over and over again. Just defensive stop after defensive stop after defensive stop. Even when the Coyotes get close to the goal line, we do not. They always just try to be a little bit extra aggressive and go for it, and doesn't really pay off for them here.
They're making Rudy Alcala look great.
Definitely. We haven't seen much of actually the passing game, really. We haven't seen big passes, many of those big runs by Caleb Huss. This is the punt here. There, Declan Healy, you can just get us, let it roll. And it's going to be eventually picked up there at the 35-yard line by Miguel Mercado.
Miguel Mercado, yeah.
We're just chewing the clock here. That's the whole game plan. Nothing flashy whatsoever. Just
there's no need.
Yeah, there's really no need. You're up by 21 in the third quarter. More than halfway through the third quarter. You're just going to run.
I mean, it is amusing to see that the Coyotes fumble the ball around a little bit. And there's a handoff to, I believe that is Caleb Hunt. Oh, little rumble of double. Love to see it. Oh, that's not. That is. That's number 16, Kaiden Ordonez. Don't see much of him.
He's really the almost fourth string running back after Caleb Haas, Declan Haley.
Well, I mean, look at the score. Might as well put him in.
We've actually seen more of him in the earlier games. Just once again, just another run up the middle here.
That was a pickup of two. Now at third and six with 3 minutes, 20 seconds on the clock. At this time, we would like to bring up a sponsorship. Bring your best smile forward with Philosophy Dental and Ortho. Everyone has a story. They're here to make sure yours is full of smiles.
Pass intended that time for Declan Healy.
Definitely a lot from Declan Healy this game. Definitely a name worth mentioning a lot. We've not gotten a lot of Vander Blue.
We have not at all. Maybe one, two receptions this game.
Yeah, the only thing we've really seen him on is the punting team.
Yeah.
It's not a normal thing for Vander Blue. I kind of want to see it. Oh, is this? Oh, never mind. Sorry.
So a little bit of a delayed punt there. And it's going to roll in the Warriors' favor. That's going to give them the Coyotes terrible field position to start the drive. 11 at their own 11-yard line. Quick update here on our Freeway League. Troy is currently 7-4, tied with Sunny Hills right now. However, Sunny Hills is playing La Habra, and guess what, folks? They are losing to La Habra, 45-0. So after La Habra definitely takes that win, the Troy Warriors will be number one in Freeway League for the first time in a long time, actually.
Really? I thought last year they won the league. I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Recall how maybe La Habra beat them out last year.
Oh, I think they did lose to La Habra, actually. Now that you mention it, I think they did.
They lost to La Habra in Full Hill last year. See what Saxon and the BP offense is cooking up here. Just a handoff.
Right up the middle.
Right up the middle to the
And he's
shifty,
still going.
Man. Still going. Yeah.
Oh, we got a little. It's kind of a heated game tonight. Lots of extra shoving.
Sorry, right now Sonora is actually number one at 6-1. We are 4-3. Sonora is playing Fullerton, and they are losing 28-21.
If you recall, we won against Fullerton.
We did beat Fullerton 35-34 because of that blocked extra point by Jacob Warner. Let's see what Saxton comes up with here. Just another handoff here, this time to number five, Washington, who's going down the sideline still.
Bad tackles
after bad tackle, being hawked down there, and finally breaks
the final tackle.
It's a touchdown for Danny Washington after frankly very boring football for a couple plays. Danny Washington electrifies the Buena Park crowd with that long touchdown run, just didn't go down.
That Warrior defense just slacked off. Like
terrible
crazy.
Tackling there that by the Warrior defense.
Yeah, we saw that Trent Palmer was having some trouble trying to keep up with him. And Trent Palmer is supposed to be one of the fastest guys on the team.
Trent Palmer there did almost catch up to him, but Washington just broke off.
I don't think he timed it right, actually. I don't think he timed his jump right.
Well, that's going to definitely be a morale booster. I don't know how much it will affect the final outcome of this game. With 2 minutes left in the third quarter, they're now down by 15 here, pending the extra point.
I would love to see a two-point conversion, actually. That'd be kind of
cool.
Real no
need for the two-point conversion.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, why not make it fun?
It's something fun, as we see. Number 58, good. That number 58 being Angel Ear, the backup kicker actually there for the Coyotes. A lefty kicker, just like me here.
I am me, actually. I'm a lefty, too. I played on the left wing in my soccer days, yeah.
Let's see how the Warriors respond to that. I don't know how much their game plan will change after just the run.
Yeah, I mean, no need to. But right now, we would... Right now, we would like to thank Fratellino's Italian Kitchen and Nothing Bunk Cakes for generously feeding our Warriors before the game.
And a special thanks to next week's pregame dinner sponsors, Roman, Husina, and Patty's Cakes. You can get a full list of our sponsors on the Troy Football website at troyhsfootball.com.
You know, I actually have a connection with the owners of Fratellino's son. Yeah, because I played on the field with him in my soccer days. He was a striker and I was the winger.
Oh.
Yeah.
Interesting there.
That would be Gianni Lomelli.
See, once again, here 58 for a kickoff. Angel. It's one of the better kickoffs we've seen by the Coyotes, but high. Caleb Huss fields it around the 20-yard line. Just goes down there.
I think a turf monster got him.
Yeah, at the 30-yard line. Pretty good field position here for the Warriors. Not really looking to do much here other than just run, shoot the clock.
There's really no need to do a lot or really try a lot because they're up by 2 touchdowns.
Yeah.
Really no need to.
They want to end the quarter on this drive here. Of course, touchdown. When would you not like a touchdown? But
kind of saw in the bottom part of your screen that Trent Palmer was a little upset at himself for letting
Washington
run by.
Let's see who they hand the ball off to here. You know what's really interesting about that formation is that there are 3 different people that they can hand the ball off to, which causes a lot of confusion for the Winter Park defense.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they have Caleb Huss, Ethan Muntz, and
Declan Healy.
So and Kaiden.
Kaiden. But yeah. In the formation there, you could hand it off to the quote-unquote fullback, Ethan Munt, or hand it off to the running back, Caleb Huss, or even on the sweep for the end around, Declan Healy. There's so many options. Such a versatile formation.
Yeah. And it's definitely helped out the Warriors in this game.
Or you could just run the play action and throw it downfield.
Right. Maybe to some Vander Blue.
Definitely the number one formation. As this time they hand it off here to Kyan Ordonez.
Oh, jumped the hurdle.
Skips over a defender, brought down there, a couple of yards shy of midfield. Picks up around 16 yards there on the carry for a new set of downs. And the clock continues to tick.
Tick tock. 57 seconds.
Winter Park does not like the situation that they're in right now.
I don't think anybody would like the situation that they're in.
As you see, Caleb Huss on the handoff this time. And
he's broken free.
He has a lot of green grass in front of him. Can he get to the end zone? It's a foot race. 3.
Oh, and he fumbled it. The ball. And Winter Park recovers.
Fumbles the ball. Caleb Huss, so much green grass in front of them. Eventually stripped there that time by the 3 Coyotes. What has this game turned into? See a replay here. The punch out there by number 4, that being Hakeem Frampton. Not a name we said on defense a lot.
No, but a lot on offense.
Yeah. But all of a sudden, this game is now a 2-score game. But the Coyotes have the ball with 38 seconds left. If they can score, get a quick stop, and score again, this game suddenly is a competition all of a sudden after being 21-0.
I truly did not expect that to happen. I mean, I didn't even expect them to catch up to Caleb Huss,
but
considering how fast he is.
All that relies on the Winter Park offense being able to produce something of content here. They've just had a breakout run. That's the only score they've had so far. Let's see.
And it's up to the Warrior defense to not...
will not allow that yet.
Yeah.
To see a handoff here. A little bit of jet sweep to Anthony Irons, who's going to get pushed out that time there by Josh King.
Got a little whiplash. We'd like to say happy birthday to the Navy. 248 years. Wow, that's a whole lot of generations in the Navy.
Saw our own Warrior JRTC present the nation's colors earlier this game.
We see
a handoff this time here to Jerron Johnson Jr.
And he's getting pushed back.
We've seen a lot of these like collective grab and push back things, which really are unnecessary though. Football could cause some injuries.
Yeah,
because they're gonna give him forward progress anyway.
I mean, this is high school football, and at the end of the day, we don't want to see anybody injured.
Yeah, definitely not any live cheating injuries here. And triple zeros here in the third quarter. Fourth quarter, 12 minutes remain in a two-score game here. Buena Park has the ball at the 39-yard line, second and four once we come back.
I didn't know if you know this, but we are sitting up here in the box with a former
Naval Commander, Mr. Alan Stubblefield, who is our scoreboard operator and has been our scoreboard operator for many years now. As you can see at the bottom left of your screen, the end of the third, that 21-7, all like this down the yards to go. That's all Commander Stubblefield. So we'd like to give a great thank you to Commander Stubblefield.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Also, up here next is Marty here, who's been the stadium announcer. Just a really great personality.
It's really fun to be around.
Really fun to be around. Really gets the crowd going with, I know you guys all hear it at home, but everybody up for the kickoff.
Yeah, that's always a great thing to hear. It just brings a certain vibe up here to the press box. I've certainly enjoyed being up here in this presence of all these great people. I've always felt welcomed, and here at Fullerton Stadium is not something I thought I would ever say, but I really do enjoy being here.
Hey, right now it's our home stadium, not Fullerton.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, we're in very close proximity to the Fullerton High School. And y'all know how I feel about them.
Let's see what Saxton offense will come up with on this crucial drive here. Definitely looking for a big play here. They can get a quick touchdown that will allow them more time to get a stop. You see another guy in motion as
zone
they
coverage.
Hand it off there to Irons, who jukes back, cuts back to the left side of the field. Let's see, we have, and Declan Healy finally pushes him out of bounds there.
Oh, a little late hit by number 14, Derek Rubakava.
Irons calling for some sort of flag there, not given.
I saw it, and I wasn't even looking at the screen. I was looking out on the field.
All the way on the other side of the field.
Yeah, maybe you and I should be refs.
I do give credit to all these wrestlers for like coming out here, doing a pretty good,
a decent job
here, but definitely putting all their bias, potential bias aside. As we see another handoff here to Irons, who was looking to do the same thing, but that time wrapped up and brought down by number 43, that being Caleb Quiroz, the 6'1", 205 junior. Irons was looking to do the same thing. He came up on the jet sweep there, the reverse, cuts back, but Kiro said, no, you're not going all the way out there, and wraps him up for a gain of none there. Second and 10 here at the 48-yard line now.
Oh, a little shift in the centers.
Once again, see Irons in motion. This time they hand it off to the shifty back.
Oh.
Who's break going up the middle. Tries to truck forward. Stop there. That being Jaden Moore, who every time he's gotten the ball has just exploded. He's been so quick and agile with the ball in his hands.
You know, these coaches, they train their players in the weight room to have that explosiveness. They use the weights to further...
Improve.
There you go.
Oh, we saw a jump there by a Warrior corner. I believe that was number 14, Derek Rubalcava. That's going to be...
We don't really say his name for flags.
He's been pretty good about the flags, but that time he jumps That's going to bring the Coyotes up 5 yards. First and five now with 10:49 left in third quarter. That helps out the BP case.
Does it?
I mean, 5 yards is 5 yards.
All right, yeah.
See three receivers to the left. He throws a screen there, and he's going.
Oh,
the
he broke three tackles.
The receivers and
fumble, and it was recovered. Is it?
They call him. They call the ball carrier down before he lost possession of the ball.
Debatable.
Pick up of around 15 yards there on the carry or the reception.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. I feel like he should have.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line. I don't know when they lost possession, but obviously challenge flags aren't a thing.
Not in high school football,
Not in high school football. Although we do have replays, as you guys are enjoying.
We got the VAR here.
As we see another similar play. Number four this time, the reception.
And he's wrapped up by two
wrapped up
warriors.
There. We saw Saxon just stare at the receiver there, number four, Hakeem Frampton, for about a good 2 seconds before deciding to throw it to him. Caleb Kears maybe could have jumped that, read the quarterback's eyes in that time.
BP is pretty close to coming in for another touchdown. What do you think? Do you think they're going to get it?
We'll see. I mean, they've been sputtering out near the goal line for every drive, basically.
Yeah.
As you see, another shift in the guard and center. Snap there. Hand off to...
And he tripped, I think.
Maybe a little bit of confusion about who the handoff was going to.
The turf monster. We'll blame it on the turf monster. But those running backs for BP, they've certainly been holding up this team.
Jaden Moore, Jerron Johnson Jr., and of course Danny Washington, who had that 80-some yard touchdown. Let's see now, 3rd and 10 now. Kind of a tough situation at the 12-yard line. Defense gets, especially zone defense, gets much easier once you're closer to the end zone because there's less ground to cover. Safeties can target more on a specific player. As we see Saxton keep it on the option there. Goes forward for about 8 yards. Not enough of the first down.
That's risky.
The read option, basically. That's when we have 4th and 3 at the 5-yard line. Really have to go for this, but our defense on 4th downs has not let up a single conversion yet. And amid the crucial play, Coyotes decide to call a timeout. That's going to leave them with 2 timeouts left in the 8 minutes remaining. When they come back, 4th and 3 at the 5-yard line for the Coyotes.
These Coyotes have to score 2 touchdowns in 8 minutes.
As 4th and 3 now, ball on the 5-yard line. Coyotes could hypothetically get a first down without a touchdown. It's getting to be a bit tough. I think they might go with a slant here. Two of the receivers to the left, looking to his right. He sees
incomplete.
And it's incomplete there at that time. The Irons the tiniest bit of a shove there by Jacob Wong right now. I don't think it was enough to call it pass interference.
No.
But guess what? That is not your first. That is not your second. It is your third turnover on downs.
Yep, it is
here.
Third.
All of them have been inside the 10. The Warriors have had exceptional goal line defense, headlined by that goal line stop in the Habro. The last play of the game was 4th-and-1. They had to get the stop to win the game, and our defense stopped the Highlanders. Here we see another handoff up the middle. Goes for 2 yards.
Yeah, I would say 2 yards. I think right now VP is just, they're looking for those running backs. They're practically hunting them.
Maybe force another fumble. That's what they really want.
Yeah. Yeah, especially right here. The Warrior offense waiting to see what their next play is going to be. Here we go.
Getting 3 yards in a cloud of dust football now. As you see, a handoff here to Declan Healy, who's looking
and
for some
not
space.
Not much.
He's
I would
none.
Say like a yard or two.
Maybe even a loss on the play there.
Yeah.
Loss of one, I believe they'll give him. Yeah. That's going to bring out 3rd-and-9 now on the 6-yard line.
Bring out Vander. Nothing from Vander this game.
They haven't really needed to utilize him, but come on, it's Vander Plouffe.
Right. I feel like you should.
See Josh King walking out onto the field there with Rudy Alcala. Let's see what the play is here. 3rd-and-9. You could pass it here. You could run 2 clock and punt. I think the safe play here would be a screen or maybe a run. Let's see what the Warriors do. They do hand the ball off and he's stuffed.
Smothered.
I gotta say, the Coyotes defense, these past few drives have been really good, although they basically expect to run every play.
But like I said, they're just hunting the running backs of the Troy Warriors.
After the whistle, 54 just ripped the ball from the ball carrier there. Held it to the official. It was a forced fumble. As the punt team is now walking out onto the field. Vander Plouffe deep in his own end zone punting.
Ooh, look at that.
As we see, BP go for an aggressive punt block almost here.
Oh,
but
shot.
A high punt, but a bit short. Feel around the 40-yard line. They're caught by Jerron Johnson Jr. And that's going to be 5:39 left in the game. Buena Park down by 14 at the 38-yard line here.
Yeah, there's not much to expect from them. I mean,
short of a miracle.
Yeah, here we are seeing the Warriors park the bus, like I said, they should. But when you have a desperate amount of people trying to score or trying to do anything, it's most likely going to happen. If they want it enough, if they want this win, they're going to have to try really hard.
Definitely. As it is with all wins.
Right. It's just about sheer will here.
What BP does with the ball here. They're going to pass it here. Rolls out right. Throws it to no one. Intended there, actually, for Aaron Rodriguez.
Yeah. He was getting pressured out to his right, and he just had no choice.
That's going to be incomplete, out of bounds. 2nd-and-10, 38-yard line. Does stop the clock, though. But as we said, early in this game, they used the pass as an extension of the run. We haven't seen a lot of big passes other than like the scramble drill or like just improvised passes. Mainly all the design reads have been just extension of the run game. Those short quick passes, those screens, those curls, the slants.
Well, we
just see a run here with Jaden Moore going up, jukes
oh
a man out of
God.
His shoes. What a run there.
I think he started skiing on how much his sliding there was.
Jaden Moore, great run there.
Ooh, look at that moves.
Ooh, that's going to be on a highlight reel somewhere.
Yeah, and then the tackle is made by Trent Palmer. We've actually said Trent Palmer's name quite a few times.
You see, Chip's right here. Maybe a pass with a sack.
And a flag on field.
Is a flag display or a football game?
That is on the Coyotes.
Coyotes, so it's going to be offside. It's going to go back
five yards.
First and 15 now, 20-yard line.
5:18 on the clock. Fourth quarter.
Warriors, if they win this game, will improve to 5-3 overall.
And 3-0 in league.
That's the big thing.
Yeah.
And another
or a timeout? I think it's a timeout. Oh, never mind. There's a flag.
Another flag on the Coyotes. Is this the second team? Maybe third team at this point?
Yeah.
All these flags on the Coyotes.
We did play.
Another false start here. Make them back. Put them back even more yards.
I feel like it's harder to get a false start when you're on offense. You usually see it from the defense who's getting the
false
starts.
On the offense, unlike the offensive line. As we see, Saxton, a lot of time, throws it towards the end zone. Ooh.
Oh, maybe a little PI there.
Pass intended there for Anthony Irons. That time, Raheem Moorhead.
Let's say Anthony Irons. Brother?
See, Anthony Irons was the one calling for the flag.
Get that ball back.
Let's see what Saxton does now. They really got that end zone shot. I don't hate it at all. They really have to go end zone or nothing here. Second 20.
We don't see a lot of man coverage, huh?
Washington out in motion. Batted down that time by the Warriors defense.
I was read like a book.
Aaron Rodriguez might have thought that. Don't exactly know who the pass was intended to, whether it was Danny Washington or Aaron Rodriguez.
I would say it was Aaron Rodriguez.
Pass a little bit behind him. Almost a backwards pass to cause a fumble, but a little bit forward, almost on the parallel, actually. As you see, five wide, three receivers to the right, to the left. Third and 20. I'm setting pressure here, dropping back six. Let's see. See a lot of options for Saxton.
And it is intercepted!
Intercepted that time.
He looks a little confused on whether or not it is.
Is that Josh King with the interception?
That is Josh King, our very own Josh King.
Vanderhyper, Saxton. Josh King just scoops it off the ground, looking at the referees to see whether it's an interception or not.
Hey, number 81, Josh King.
And
definitely didn't see that one come. He just scooped it right up. He kind of launched for it, actually.
See, run here. First down, outside, right sideline run.
Josh King had a fumble recovery last week.
The sealed deal against La Habra, that last play. Still talked about to this day. referring it to the stop.
The stop. It's called the stop against La Habra last week. Now, you know what? I think it should go down in history because that has been a very long time since Troy has beat La Habra. Since 2006. That was when I was born.
I was not even born the last time we beat La Habra, as that's a pretty good run there that time.
Oh, big hit.
Big hit. That's Kai Nordonez. And his shoulder pads out of his jersey. That's how big of a hit it was.
Yeah. Got a little whiplash on there. Boom.
Ooh.
Great tackle.
Got up on sheet. Looks to be good. First down. really going to chew the clock. This game not going to go on much longer.
Yeah, we got 3:30 left on the clock. First and 10. Not much left to do. You know what? But at least BP isn't going down without a fight. Seen him score here. I wouldn't call it a great score, but
as you see, Kyle Ordonez there with another run.
It was more of the defense not doing that great of a job of tackling.
See, once again, that nicely wrapped up that time by Jacob Taylor, sophomore. First time I've said his name all night.
Yeah. Got to make a name for yourself.
That's definitely what these late game garbage time, dare I say, situations are for. Just really for these players, like maybe even Ethan Munt might have been birthed out of one of these garbage time situations.
That's true, huh? Ethan Munt wasn't a huge name at the beginning of the season, but now look at him. Final home game, and he's...
We're doing amazing.
Yeah, it's been very effective.
Run that time by Declan Healy. Declan Healy and Akeem Frampton exchange some words here. That's going to be 3rd and 7 now, 36-yard line. And now Buena Park's going to call a timeout. So it's going to be, they're going to be left with one timeout left in regulation.
Got some positive comments in our live stream here.
Thank you, Mr. Street.
And we want to say right now just to like this and to subscribe to our channel.
DRHS Omni broadcast all of the home varsity games for Troy High School.
Yeah. We do football, water polo,
basketball, soccer, but
wrestling. You name it.
As 2:20 is now on the clock, not much drama likely to happen in the final moments of the game.
I doubt
final
that.
Minutes. See, a pass actually here this time. Finally a pass, first time we've seen it in a while, that time to Declan Healy, getting the PPR interception there. Declan Healy, that's going to be another first down, so we're just going to chew the clock.
Yeah, why not? I mean, they have 2:14 on the clock. Not really much else to do. They've certainly shown that they can be here on this field with anybody. Good, bad, medium. Rudy Alcala certainly has proved himself this game. But I really do want to show off to running backs. Like right there, Caleb Huss just storms through all those guys. And Ethan Munt, Kaiden, all the RBs out there. Just doing a great job in this game. Really just settling score here. Rivals, not our rivals per se. Let's say that for Sunny Hills, but our local team.
Crosstown rivals here.
There it is, crosstown rivals. Fullerton, our leading score by one touchdown, 28-21 against Sonora.
If Fullerton Indians win this game, we as Warriors have to root for the Indians, which is not something I want to say. We have to root for the Indians here to win this game so that Sonora goes down to 6-2 and we improve to 5-3. We're still 3-0 in league, so if Sonora loses this game, they won't be 3-0 in league. As this time we see another run.
I don't know if
that's going to be a quarterback keeper. Yeah, I was confused. I didn't see a handoff at all. That's going to be a keeper for Rudy Alcala.
Not much there, but
You know what I want to see right now? I want to see the Warriors experiment with a different QB right now. Rudy Okala, there's no need for him to be in the game.
No.
Up 14.
Yeah, I mean.
They have number 13, Andrew Okuna, listed as a backup quarterback here, the 5'8 sophomore.
I would put him in. I mean, just give him some play time.
Yeah. See how he would pan out.
I think I've seen a lot, enough from Rudy.
And we see a patient run here this time by
Caleb Huss.
Caleb Huss.
Back in his OG spot.
Yep.
They must have heard us say that we wanted Caleb Huss back in.
We want to see a lot of Caleb Huss. We want to see a lot of everyone now.
Yeah, we do.
But Vander has been quiet this game.
Yeah, he really has. There's only 48 seconds on the clock and nothing from Vander. It's very surprising.
And now in victory formation, the Warriors here going to kneel it down. And that is all she wrote. The Troy Warriors with 21 points. Those two explosive Declan Healy touchdowns. The one-yard QB sneak. That brings the Warriors total up to 21. That 180-yard run there by Washington. Winter Park 7. And that is going to be a victory for the Warriors here. Thank you to everyone who came out to support the stream. Thank you to all the viewers. Thank you to everyone in attendance who came and watched. Thank you to all the staff. Thank you to administration.
We have certainly enjoyed being your football announcers. Me being Ian Diaz.
And myself, Soham Dev. And this Friday the 13th, October, your last football game, your last home football game for the 2023-2024 season.
But hey, don't be sad. We'll be back for soccer. Well, at least I'll be back, and maybe Soham will be next to me for the boys and girls soccer announcers.
Once again, we'd like to thank everyone, staff, administration, viewers, and taking the PSAT tomorrow. Wish you the best of luck.
Yeah, good luck, guys. Good luck. Even though it's just a practice of the SAT, it's still important. I know that.
Very important.
Sure. Yeah.